Today I'm going to share three tips with you about how to get your foot in the door as a graphic designer in athletics. If you want to be a freelancer or a graphic designer for a professional team of any sport or a collegiate team of any sport, I'm going to be sharing with you the three big tips that I have right now based on my experience. The very first thing that I want to tell you to start out with is start right now. If you're thinking about graphic design or you're thinking, oh, that might be cool, I would just go ahead and tell you to start right now. With multiple things in my experience, the key is just to start. And, you know, nobody is good when they first start. I was terrible when I first started. I literally had no idea what I was doing or what I was getting myself into. I had never taken any classes. I was always terrible at drawing. Didn't have any experience in the graphic design world when I started out. And so for me, the way I started was I had some connections with people that knew the graphic designer at NC State, and I started an internship with them. And so that's how I started doing it. But I would advise you to start before anything happens. If you like doing graphic design and that's what you want to do, you should already be making graphics. You should be practicing, you know, making a graphic for your favorite athlete or your favorite team. And the more you make graphics, the better you're gonna get. And so that's like the first tip I'll give you, is just to start right now. Start as soon as this video turns off, make your first graphic, and then tell me about it and tell me how it turned out. The second tip I'll give you is when you start making graphics, you need, even though, you know, I don't even like social media a lot of the time because it just, like, you know, it makes people depressed and it takes up too much time and it's just like, blah. But I use it because I use it as a professional avenue, and I used to have a personal Twitter and I used to have kind of a personal Instagram, but I've made both of them into like more business accounts kind of. I post more design stuff with my App State job on my Twitter. And I use Instagram more for photography and that sort of thing, photography, videography, even though I do post some design stuff on there. But I would advise you to make a Twitter, make an Instagram, because you want to build connections and you want to be able to put your work out there so that people can see it. Because if no one can see your work, it's going to be harder for you to make connections and get jobs, because especially in the sports world, getting jobs is a lot about having the connections to get the jobs. So yeah, you want to get your name out there, make a Twitter, make an Instagram, start posting your work, start following other creators. One of the big things to do for sure, if you're going to be a graphic designer in athletics, you should definitely be following Skull Sparks. And there are multiple other pages like them, but Skull Sparks will definitely kind of get your foot in the door as far as like creatives in college athletics. They're all about college athletics, but the people who follow them and the people in the Skull Sparks community are not just college athletics people. There will be people from, you know, professional teams and even like outside of sports who follow them, because Skull Sparks is always posting great work from the different designers in the college athletics community, and they really are a great community. Like, graphic designers in sports is a huge group on Twitter. I would advise you to follow your favorite designers and just like search for the people that make the best designs or the designs that you like the best. Try and use their work as inspiration. Don't copy their work. That's a huge no-no in graphic design, is copying other people. You do not want to be the person who copies other people's work. But you definitely do want to use their work as inspiration and like pull ideas and textures and things from different designs and create your own work. You'll find a lot of inspiration and people in the same position as you, or people right ahead of you or right below you, who are all, you know, just trying to have success in the graphic design community. And so yeah, make those accounts, start following people on Twitter and Instagram, and use their work as inspiration. And even like, you know, comment, tell them you like it. And like, you know, maybe they'll say, oh, well, your stuff's cool too, you should come be an intern for me. Or something like that. You just never know what's gonna happen on social media if you're interacting with people and looking at their work and posting your own work. There are plenty of posts that people make saying, post your latest work right here. And so you can post and people will comment and like and say this, that, and the other. But don't compare yourself to others, because that is what will take you down a path that you don't want to go down. That's the bad part about social media, is comparing yourself to others and seeing how good other people's work is. The problem is, like, if you are comparing yourself to someone who's been doing this for like 20 years, obviously they're going to be a lot better than you because they have more experience. But you'll get there. You just got to keep practicing and keep working. One of the ways to do that, which is the third tip that I have, is get an internship. Internships and experience is going to help you a ton. You need someone that you can learn from on a weekly or daily basis that is going to tell you the ins and outs of graphic design and sports, and like show you what you're doing right, what you're doing wrong, kind of push you in better directions if you start to, you know, make mistakes. I remember when I first started, I worked under the graphic designer for NC State Athletics. His name is McLean Roberts. He's incredible. All of his work is like amazing. And like whenever he makes basketball or football posters, it's just like, how? You know, he taught me like basically everything I know, and I would not be where I am right now if it wasn't for him, for sure. Because I didn't go to college for graphic design or design at all. I took a few design classes, but they didn't even have anything to do with graphic design. And so basically, for me, school is not what helped me get to where I am. I mean, I attended NC State, so in the end, like, I needed to attend NC State, or it was good that I attended NC State, because that led to me working under McLean for NC State Athletics. He is really the one, him and Chris, who works there now, they're really the ones who like taught me what I need to know, and you know, made me do things that they're not always necessarily fun, but they will help you down the line. Even now, I still go back and ask them questions about certain things, and like anyone you can learn from is a huge deal, because you need guidance, especially when you're starting out, at least in like your first few years. I really think it helps to have someone who can kind of point you in the right direction. So along with that, kind of like an extra tip is to watch YouTube tutorials. YouTube University is a great way to learn. I don't know how much information there is out there on sports graphics, but I'm sure you can learn a lot from YouTube, because I have learned a lot from YouTube in multiple areas of the creative field. So whether it's watching this video or watching someone else make a graphic or something, or learning how to use Photoshop, or learning how to use Illustrator, which I can't even do. Yeah, I would advise you to start watching YouTube videos as well. If you don't know how to do something, look it up. If you have an idea, see if someone else has done it already and look up how they did it. So yeah, so start as soon as possible, as soon as this video goes off, put your work out there and connect with people. Try and make as many connections as possible and use other people's work as inspiration. Again, follow Skull Sparks. And then thirdly, get an internship. Learn from someone. Get someone to teach you on a daily or weekly basis how they do things and what looks good, what doesn't look good, because it's going to help you a lot down the line. And then lastly, watch YouTube videos like this.